And what I'm afraid of doing as I go around the country is that I'm seeing how this idolization has crept into the church. I'm sure you've met preachers who the church, they have come to the point that they don't just love the pastor, they worship him. And some of these cats got more security than George Bush, but don't have but 75 members and nobody knows their name. And you can't even shake some of these cats' hands. Listen, the Bible says we have not a high priest who cannot be touched with the feeling of our infirmity. Now, something wrong with that when you can touch Jesus, but you can't touch the pastor. I tell my members, I appreciate the fact that y'all love me and respect me, but whatever you do, don't worship me because I'm just a man. My calling is from God, but I came from the ground. My calling is divine, but I came from the dust. My calling is from the sky, but I came from the soil. Don't worship me. So sometimes, in order to help other folk to have a proper estimation of the leader, God has to let the leader bleed. That was given to me. Thorn in my flesh. But wait a minute, there's another purpose. Not only was it to remind others of his humanity, but it was also so that he could retain his humility. Verse 7, and lest I should be exalted above measure by the abundance of the revelations. Paul now turns the spotlight of critical analysis upon himself. He had gone to the third heaven. He had seen what nobody else had ever seen. And with that kind of ministerial success, Paul understood that there's often a correlation between success and conceitedness, success and getting the big head. So he said, in order to keep my feet squarely on the ground, there was given to me, gifted to me, a thorn in my flesh. I believe God wants to bless some of us, but God can't afford to bless some of us. Because when some of us make a nickel more than others, we walk around with our nose in the air. Your nose so far in the air until if it rained, you would drown. So in order to keep your feet on the ground, there was given a thorn in the flesh.